and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess,
Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwell in a land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed as on the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us, upon his shoulder dominion rests. They named him Wonder Counselor, God of Europe, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful, from David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I
reading from the letter of St. Paul to Titus. Beloved, the grace of God has appeared, saving all, and training us to reject godless ways and worldly desires, and to live temperately, justly, and devoutly in this age, as we await the blessed hope, the appearance of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to deliver us from all lawlessness and to cleanse for himself a people as his own, eager to do what is good. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were shepherds in that region living in the fields and keeping the night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Christ and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
On this Christmas night, we are prepared for this great liturgy by singing some familiar songs together that celebrate the joy and wonder of what took place over 2,000 years ago in a humble setting normally used for the feeding of animals. One of the most familiar and most loved songs often sung comes from Handel's Messiah and is based on the stirring words of our first reading from the great prophet Isaiah. And that song is, "Unto us a child is born." Isaiah wrote these words when everything was going wrong. He spoke about someone to come who would set things right. "The people in darkness have seen a great light, for a son is born to us. He will be a wonderful counselor like Solomon, a mighty warrior like David, and a father forever. He will reign a long time. He will be a prince who brings peace." This became a song of hope, sung in the dark world looking for a person of light. But no king in that period following David for hundreds of years could fit that description, until that one night in that most humble setting, a child was born who would fulfill all the hopes proclaimed in the prophecies of Isaiah. As we celebrate the birth of our salvation, we can thank Isaiah for his message of hope for the long-suffering people of the kingdom of Judah, a people who had lost hope during a period of slavery and exile. His message will speak for generations to come. Today's passage from Isaiah presents a vision of hope to be realized in a ruler who would end the era of suffering, slavery, and exile. A king would truly be a light for those who had lived in the darkness of sin, of exile from God for so long. But of course, God never forgets his people, and he will never forget us. In our gospel, Luke presents the birth of this Savior, King Jesus Christ, as a source of hope to counter the Caesars that had caused so much suffering and destruction in his day. He came to rescue us, to free us from those forces that enslave us. This King of Kings, born in the poorest of circumstances, makes his first outreach to the street people of his day, the lowly shepherds. And with this outreach, he sends a special message of hope for all those who are suffering. those who feel marginalized, those looked down on because of their seemingly low status. He says, I want to be a part of your lives, as messy as they might be. And I am here for you, I am with you. I am among you, I share your poverty, I share your struggle. Paul sums up the importance of this Christmas night. He invites us to look back to when the grace of God, Jesus Christ, appeared to save us, to give us real hope. But he directs us to look forward, fueled by this hope, to the day when Christ will come again. But then he suddenly instructs us that the best way to look forward is by living lives of virtue in the present. In other words, to walk the way of Jesus, to walk in step with Jesus, to come home to Jesus. Coming home is what so many do at Christmas. We come home from college to be with our parents and brothers and sisters. We come home to visit old friends. Sometimes we come home to our faith, faith that at one time nurtured our hopes and dreams. The faith that got us through the tough times. The faith that from time to time enabled us to feel that we were really close to God. But we lost that closeness for reasons that we may have long forgotten. The timeless Christmas story of God coming into this world can move us to once again want to draw closer to Him, because we come to know that He is the source of real hope in what for many of us are most challenging times. It is my hope that these Christmas messages of hope from the Word of God and the inspired music may especially speak to those who are here today, because someone or something has caused them to think about coming home to their Catholic faith. Perhaps it was an invitation of a family member, a friend, or a co-worker. This urge to come home may have been inspired by one of the many powerful invitations that have been offered on the major networks in this area since December 6th. I hope you've seen some of those. They're beautiful. Or it may have been the fruit of the prayers that have been offered in our parish and throughout the diocese for the past month. Thousands and thousands of prayers. Whatever brought you home, we welcome you and look forward to getting reacquainted and providing you with the support that Jesus Christ will provide for you through His church. I invite you in His name to take this new opportunity to make His gospel, to make His church, His sacraments, especially His Eucharist, an important part of your life, the most important part of your life. You will find gradually coming to life again within yourself something stronger, deeper, wiser, and holier than you have known for a long time. This invitation is not just for those, of course, who have come home this night. It is for all of us gathered here, regardless of our circumstance. We are people of hope. And our hope is in Jesus Christ. And it is our hope in Him that is cause for great joy. For tonight we joyfully proclaim to the world that our salvation is at hand. God has come among us in human form, born in those humblest of circumstances to save us. And more than that, He has come to take us home. And in that, we can rejoice.
Thank you.
Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is the Lord and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
As we celebrate with joy the feast of our salvation, we pray that the light sent to us from God will remain with us and satisfy our every need.
Phil Steinberg.